acid and bases. Today we are going to study about the topic acid and base. How can we differentiate between acid and base? Commonly by taste, acids are sour and bases are bitter. Acids are corrosive to skin, can damage our skin. In concentrated form, it's almost it can burn. While bases are slippery in touch, like soap, commonly. Acids turn blue litmus paper red, while bases turn red litmus paper blue. Common examples in our natural acids is citric acid, present in lemon, sodium hydroxide, the commonly known base. Solutions of aqueous solution, acid and bases can conduct electricity, both acid and bases. So these are the common characteristics on the basis of these common characteristics, we can identify or differentiate between acid and bases. The next is the concept about, these are the basic things. So now we are going to understand about the different concept of acid and bases. So for first time, we will study the concept of Arrhenius concept about acid and bases. This concept was presented in nearly 1787, and to explain the nature of acids, that how as we can identify the acids. For example, he said that if we consider a general example of this one, for example, in water. So in this way, this one is an acid that ionizes in water to give H positive ions. So commonly acids, when ionize in water, they give H positive ions, while bases, when ionize in water, they give OH ions. Generally, you can say HCl give us H positive ions and Cl negative, right? HNO3 give us H positive ions and NO3 negative. Acetic acid CH3COOH give us Ca So all these acids, when ionize in water, they give H positive ions. So acids, about acid, Arrhenius says when you dissolve acids in water, they dissociates into or break down into H positive ions and negative parts, chlorine ions, like this, like nitrates, like acetic acid or H positive ions, acetate ions. So in this way, you can identify acid and bases. Similarly, Arrhenius says about bases, BOH
B plus and OH negative. Alright. So you can say commonly NaOH when ionized is in water, it gives positive ions and hydroxyl ions. Similarly, KOH can ionize in water to give K plus and OH ions. So this type of reactions that ionizes in water to give OH ions are called bases. So these concepts were presented by scientists to explain the nature of acids in aqueous medium only. So now we come to the defects of Arrhenius concept about acid and bases. Number one limitation is it only explains behavior acids and bases in aqueous medium. कि ये जो एसिड और बेस का कंसेप्ट सिर्फ एक्वस मीडियम पानी के अंदर बताता है कि वो एच पॉजिटिव आयंस में कन्वर्ट हो जाएंगे या ओएच आयंस में कन्वर्ट हो जाएंगे, लेकिन ये नहीं बताता कि नॉन एक्वस मीडियम में इनका बिहेवियर कैसा होगा। सेकंड लिमिटेशन इज इट ओनली एक्सप्लेन्स hydrogen containing acids and hydroxyl containing bases. While it cannot explain acids like CO2 and bases like NH3, कि उन एसिड और बेसिस को ये एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर सकता जिनमें हाइड्रोजन और हाइड्रोक्सल ग्रुप नहीं है। तो इस वजह से ये दो लिमिटेशंस हैं इसकी, कि ये सिर्फ एक्वस मीडियम में बताता है कि एक्वस मीडियम के अंदर उनका बिहेवियर कैसा होगा, पानी में आप डालेंगे तो ये आयनाइज होके एच पॉजिटिव आयंस देंगे या ओएच आयंस देंगे। सिमिलरली ये भी बताता है, इसकी लिमिटेशन ये भी है कि कुछ ऐसे एसिड्स भी हैं जिनमें हाइड्रोजन नहीं होता लेकिन फिर भी वो एसिड्स हैं, और कुछ ऐसे बेसिस हैं जिनमें हाइड्रोक्सल नहीं होता लेकिन वो फिर भी बेसिस हैं। तो इन चीज़ों को देखते हुए जैसे ये है या ये है, इसको Arrhenius कंसेप्ट एक्सप्लेन नहीं कर सकता। तो ये वो लिमिटेशंस थी उसकी, जिसकी बेस पे यानी इसको फर्दर इन्वेस्टिगेशंस के लिए फिर आने वाले साइंटिस्ट ने बाद में अपने कंसेप्ट प्रेजेंट किए, जो कि हम अपने नेक्स्ट लेक्चर में स्टडी करेंगे।